The Five Personality Patterns, Your Guide to Understanding Yourself and Others and Developing Emotional Maturity. Written by Stephen Kessler and narrated by the author. And on the next page, we have the opening quote for the entire book. Your experience of life is determined mostly by your habits of attention and the patterned flow of your life energy. Stephen Kessler. Introduction. Much of our human suffering is not necessary. It is created by unhealthy patterns of feeling and acting, patterns that helped us survive the traumas of childhood, but then got stuck in our bodies. These patterns have shaped us so deeply that now we think that's who we are. But these patterns are not our true self. In fact, they cover up our true self and prevent it from shining out into the world. Fortunately, there is a map of these survival patterns, a map that shows us both how we got stuck and how we can free ourselves and return to being present in the moment. This book lays out that map and shows you the path out of your suffering and back to your true self. The inner journey still takes time and effort, but once you know where you're going, it will be much easier. Without a map, you may have been walking in circles for years. With a map, you can find your way home. The nature of this map. Other maps of personality, such as the Enneagram and the Myers-Briggs Type Indicator, describe a series of types and then refer to people as a type. For instance, calling them a 4 or a 9 or an ENTJ. This map is fundamentally different. It does not describe who you are, but instead describes the safety strategies you automatically go into when you start to feel overwhelmed. It is not a set of types, but a set of survival patterns that come to the fore to buffer you from directly feeling that distress. Consequently, this map does not describe who you are, but rather what obscures who you are. It focuses not just on which patterns you go into, but also on the difference between being caught in a pattern and being present, and on learning how to get out of pattern and back to being present. As you first learn about the five survival patterns and discover which ones you go into, it's easy to forget this difference. To highlight it, I will refer in this book to people going into a pattern, or being in a pattern, or doing a pattern, but I will never say that they are a pattern. Another important difference between this map and most other maps of personality is that the survival patterns are not based on what is happening at the surface, on what people say and do. Instead, they are based on what is happening within, on how the flow of awareness and the stream of life energy habitually move through the body, especially in times of distress. The five survival patterns described here arise out of five different ways that the flow of energy and awareness through the body can be shaped in an attempt to cope with distress. The flow can habitually move away from others, move toward others, move in and down, move up and out, or become constricted. These patterns of energy flow influence how a person perceives the world, and therefore what he experiences and thinks and feels. And they influence how the person behaves, especially when too much energy hits his system and he goes into overwhelm. These patterns of awareness and energy flow are so fundamental that they even shape the body as it grows. But the survival patterns are not based on body shape or emotions or behavior. They are based on how awareness and energy flow through the body. This book attempts to give you a sense of what each survival pattern feels like from the inside, so that you can understand others more deeply. It will give you a window into their world, enable you to understand how they experience themselves, and help you communicate with them more successfully. It will also give you a window into your own inner world. As you develop a better working relationship with yourself, you will begin to break the hold that your patterns have on you and more easily return to being present. The origins of this map. The map of the survival patterns is part of a larger body of work. It begins with Wilhelm Reich, a star student of Sigmund Freud, who began his career as a Freudian analyst. During the 1920s, Reich observed that his patients displayed shared patterns of character resistances. He called these patterns character structures. And over time, as he focused on understanding his patients' character structures, Reich's therapeutic method changed so much that he began calling it character analysis to distinguish it from Freud's psychoanalysis. Reich also noticed that these character structures were held in place by patterns of chronic muscular tension in the body, and he began to look for ways to loosen his patients' muscular armoring. Over time, he found that as their muscular armoring relaxed, their life energy flowed more freely through their bodies. This led to his discovery in 1935 of the orgasm reflex, which caused him to shift the focus of his therapy from the character resistances to the body itself, and to change the name of his method to vegetotherapy. This name proved unfortunate, for while it was accurate in German, it was confusing when translated into English. In 1939, Reich coined the term orgone for the life energy flowing through the body, and he began calling his method orgone therapy. Alexander Lowen, one of Reich's early students, championed Reich's concept of character structure and his body-based way of working, and further developed Reich's insights and methods into a form of therapy that he called bioenergetics. Another of Reich's students, John Pirakos, first collaborated with Lowen in the development of bioenergetics, and later he added more awareness of the spiritual dimension to create his own form of therapy, which he called core energetics. Still other students who stayed closer to Reich's teachings called themselves Neo-Reichians. Many branches grew from these roots, leading to more recent contributions by Barbara Brennan, Stephen M. Johnson, and Anodea Judith, among others. The names of the survival patterns. The names used for the patterns have evolved over time as various writers attempted to clarify the patterns and find more useful names for them. Because Reich initially perceived them as patterns of resistance, he named them for the associated psychological pathologies, using Freudian terms such as schizophrenic, passive feminine, hysterical, compulsive, masochist, and phallic narcissist. As Alexander Lowen extended Reich's work, he defined 5 clear patterns and renamed most of them, but he still used Freudian terms derived from their pathology, calling them schizoid, oral, masochist, psychopath, and rigid. In his book, Core Energetics, John Pirakos retained Lowen's 5 character structure patterns, but renamed the psychopath pattern as aggressive. Some more recent writers have tried to get away from Lowen's pathology-based terms by renaming the patterns for their associated talents and skills, giving them names such as creative, lover, communicator, inspirer, charismatic leader, industrious, and achiever. However, such names imply that the patterns are something to aspire to, rather than places we got stuck. They also distract our...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.